Welcome back. We've spent the last couple of minutes speaking with Dr. Paul Akintelure. He's a medical doctor turned politician and is aspiring to be governor in Ondo State. Thanks for staying with us.
It's my pleasure.
So let's talk about your move into politics. How did that move from medicine to politics?
It was smooth. It was a smooth move. But let me also tell you, you, Joke, you as you are here today, I'm sure when you know your friends.
Mm-hmm.
Eh? You are not. I don't know. You are somebody everybody knows now. Eh? What do you call yourself now? You are in the public glare.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody wants to say, ah, that's Joke, that's Joke. Yes, that's true. But let me tell you, as a medical doctor, eh? I think the friends I have are the poor people in the society.
Mm.
All the acquaintances, all the clients I have are poor because there's a close correlation between poverty and diseases.
Poverty and diseases, yeah,
poverty
obviously,
and
yes.
Diseases.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. So the correlation is that once you are poor, you must have diseases.
Mm-hmm.
Majority of the people in the hospitals are poor and therefore they don't also have money.
Mm-hmm.
They don't have money. So as we are going along, your friends are MDs. Your friends are people who have made it. Their friends, your friends are, but we don't have that kind of friends. Poor people. So there are many in the society. Nobody sings your praises. Nobody knows when you don't sleep.
Mm.
I want to tell you one truth. I finished job at 2:30 today, 2:30 a.m. in Lagos. I did surgery in Lagos 2:30. I did one at 12 midnight, two of them. I finished 2:30. I said I would not be on the bed. Let me just sit down. I had a lap of about 40 minutes. And I said, okay, driver, let us move.
Yeah, you are in Ondo State.
Yeah, I'm in Ondo State. You get what I'm saying? So, when it comes to saving of life, when it comes to, you know, helping and assisting survivor, I don't think I have excuses. I have learned that from school, University of Ibadan. I have also learned that from one Dr. Adeuja, who was my teacher when I got to University of Ibadan.
So, you know, you're running for the gubernatorial seat here in Ondo State. What do you think qualifies you for that job?
I was a senatorial candidate of AC in Ondo State and Ondo South. Even when everybody was running to the Labour Party or PDP that time because they were in power, I was there. I was steadfast. I was consistent. I persevered. I endured. Those are qualities that I believe is not rampant, it's not common with any other person in this race.
Mm.
My integrity, my credibility, these are what I count on. I am not indebted. I'm not insolvent.
Mm.
I am a professional in politics. I am not a politician of bitterness, or politics with bitterness. I say politics without do or die.
Mm.
If I succeed today, I think the generality of the masses of this state will benefit immensely.
Mm. Let's talk about Ondo State. What is the Ondo State of your dream? The Ondo State that you wake up and you see, the Ondo State you envision.
My Ondo State, the Ondo State of my dream is that to project what God has endowed in this state. There are a number of potentialities that God has given Ondo State. And because of bad management, because of inept leadership, because of naive leadership, because of inordinate, ambitious leadership, because of leadership without foresight, because of leadership who do not even proactive about what can happen to the state, we are in this doldrum. We have human resources. I told you now, I never saw a doctor before I became a doctor, before I became a medical student. I never saw television before I became a chess student. That's the truth. Many more like that. So the Ondo State of my dream is that we are all these resources, human and physical. When I say physical, I mean mineral resources.
Mm.
We are talking now, as I speak to you, In Ondo State, we have a lot of kaolin wasting. Nobody uses it.
Mm.
Kaolin is useful in chalk industry.
Mm-hmm.
Kaolin is useful as base for other products.
Paint, you know, production and the like.
Many more. As I speak to you, we have silicon in abundance and sand in the Ilaja and Ikale area, making the best form of glass in Nigeria. We don't do that any longer. We have abundant petroleum and gas. Today, where do we do nothing? Water resources all over. Look at Ilaja. These are tributaries to the Atlantic.
Mm-hmm.
We have seawater, we have fresh water. Therefore, we have freshwater fish, we have seawater fish. Where do we have accessories to, they are not accessible.
Mm.
We can't even see them. But because of poor management, the seawater and the fresh water, they have also linked. No survivor. No creature can survive there. Uh-huh. Because they are not adapted to that environment. We have bitumen in excess. I tell you, the bitumen in Ondo State is second to Venezuela, the largest in the world. So we are second largest in the world producing bitumen. Quality of bitumen is superb. What have we done about this? Nothing. So the resources are abundant, and this is what I'm interested in. I want to transform this state. Forget about agricultural resources, because here now, oil palm industry, oil palm plantation is abundant everywhere. We have forestry, timbers, they are all here.
Cocoa.
We have cocoa, we have cocoa yam, we have yam, we have rubber plantation. Rubber plantation, you can make tires, you can make PVC, a lot of products from this, all these products I'm talking about. So a lot of our investors, foreign investors, they have even moved to Ghana and South Africa because of the problems of corruption in Nigeria and inept leadership.
Can you tell me what your plans for the people are?
Job creation is number one. And when I mention job creation, I am talking about revitalizing agriculture. Do you get what I'm saying now?
Mm-hmm.
Agriculture is not the usual pyramid of granite and all this. We are talking about value addition. We don't need to transport that. We need to transport PKC, products. We need to transport export the oil. We need to export the byproducts and all those things. People working there will do that. I tell you, this thing I'm talking about, I've started the implementation in my own farm. As I speak to you in my farm, I produce biogas. The methane that is produced from waste, from animal dungs, from waste in the farm, has been converted to methane, and we use it to burn and to do some other things. We are going to revitalize farming. We are going to make sure that our services, in terms of bricklaying, in terms of tiling and some other things, we improve and we allow people to come and train. So, skills acquisition, vocational training, priority. Then we must also invest seriously in financial empowerment. Our petty traders must be given enough money to enable them to get their products to sell in the farm, so that we can. I'm also going to pay attention to IGR, internally generated revenue. We must expand the dragnet. The tax net of the people must be expanded, so that more people can come in and contribute, no matter how meager, because of the population of the people.
All right, as we wind to a close, let me ask you what your tallest dream is as an individual.
My tallest dream is to continue to be closer to my creator and to make sure that the people of Ondo State will say, Dr. Akintolure, when he was a ruler in Ondo State, he was great. I wanted to, I aspire to be the greatest person they will remember about. They will remember in Ondo State as a leader. And that is my aspiration. It is not about sharing money. It is not about giving money. But it's about the effect. It's about their feeling. It's about what has touched their lives. And when they do that, wherever I am, alive or in the grave, I will say, praise the Lord.
Lastly, let me ask you one thing that you know about yourself that, loads of people do not know, but you want them to know.
Well, what they don't know about myself is that I devote attention to my family. I'm talking about my nuclear family. I devote attention to nuclear family. What people don't also know about me is that I want my extended family to prosper through education. I want education to infiltrate them so that their eyes can open and everybody can enjoy and will be placed in a better position in life.
Well, thank you so much for coming on the program. We've spent the last couple of minutes speaking with Dr. Paul Akintelure. He's aspiring to be governor in Ondo State. He's a medical doctor, a farmer, hotelier, and everything all in one. Thank you very much for coming on the program.
Thank you, Joker. You didn't say I was a teacher.
And a teacher, of course. And thank you so much for watching the show. This is the Sunday Interview. I'm Joker Lijadu. I'll see you again next week. Bye for now.